Hey guys, what's up? Today we're going to draw a Pokeball inside Adobe Illustrator. I'm Kent and this is Diagraphics. So the first thing we want to do is go to View, then go to Show Grid, then go to View again and select Snap to Grid. Then go to Transform Panel. If it isn't open, you can go to Window and select your Transform Panel right here. Now select this drop-down menu right here and uncheck Align New Objects to Pixel Grid. This will make our drawing more precise. Now choose the ellipse tool and draw a circle that fills out 4 squares. Then uncheck the stroke. Select the line tool and draw a line that goes right through the middle of the circle. Now select all the shapes and go to your Pathfinder panel. And once again, if your Pathfinder panel isn't open, you can go to Window and find it in Pathfinder right here. Now click Divide in your Pathfinder panel. Go to the shape, right click it, and click Ungroup. Now the shape is divided into 2 shapes, so we can color them differently. So now choose the upper part, select the fill, and choose this standard red. Then go to the lower part and choose this very light gray. Now go to the line tool and draw a line that starts just outside the Pokeball and goes right through the middle of the ball and stops just outside the Pokeball again. And choose a width for this stroke. I will choose 10 millimeters. Now choose the ellipse tool again. And from the middle of the Pokeball, hold down the Alt key and the Shift key and draw a circle, like this. Choose the same stroke width for the circle as for the middle line. Now once again, while holding down the Alt key and the Shift key, draw a circle that is just slightly smaller than the first one. Then for this circle, choose a stroke width that is only a fifth of the first one. Now go to the Selection tool and select the middle line. Then go to Object, go to Path and go to Outline Stroke. This will turn the stroke into a shape. Now select the middle shape and the 2 parts of the ball and zoom in a little bit. Then go to the Shape Builder tool and combine these middle line parts together. Now the line is no longer overlapping, but cutting through the shapes as you can see right here. Now for a brief moment, go to View and uncheck Snap to Grid. Now while holding down the Alt key, shrink down this middle line until it fits. I will go for about half a small square. This will give the Pokeball some dimension. Now select this circle and select the fill and select the same color for the circle as the bottom part of the Pokeball. You can do the same thing for the small circle if you want. Now go back to View and once again enable Snap to Grid. Then select the bottom part of the Pokeball, go to Edit, go to Copy, then go to Edit again and select Paste in Front, then go to Edit one more time and paste in front one more time. Now we have 3 shapes stacked on top of each other. So now, while having the upper part selected, hold down the Shift key and notch this part up 2 times on the keyboard. Now hold down the Alt key and stretch it out 2 small squares. Now while having this shape selected, hold down the Shift key and select the shape underneath. Now go to the Shape Builder tool and while holding down the Alt key to subtract, delete the spare shapes like this, leaving only the shadow behind. So now select the shadow and make the shadow 2 shades darker. Now go to the ellipse tool and while holding down the Alt key, draw an ellipse at the top of the Pokeball. Choose the fill and choose the same red as the top of the Pokeball. Now double click the fill and select a lighter color red.